Hi, this is Dom's Wheel World. I'm Dom. I'm paraplegic since 2012 and developer and tester at Fossara. We are often asked why we developed a front wheel and how it differs from others. That's what this video is about. Have fun. It starts after the intro. Here we've got two front wheels, which are very similar at the first glance in terms of size and weight. On closer inspection, however, they are clearly different. Let's first look at the coupling and uncoupling to the wheelchair. This is pretty quick with both bikes. With the Fossara, there are a few more steps, but this allows a significantly higher stability to be achieved. Other attachment wheels are connected to the footboard, for example, which is not designed to take such a load. Even with little shift in weight, the wheelchair frame begins to twist. The Fossara is attached to the front tubes of the wheelchair, like a handbike, which significantly increases stability. If you look at a function of the attachment wheels, they can both, as usual, be steered over the hand ramps. Here on the left, the front rollers, when turning, come closer to the ground, which doesn't happen here on the right side. In addition, the Fossara can also be steered directly with the handlebar. You can use even the smallest slopes to roll forever and without delay. Here is the comparison with the Fossara with one hand and without pushing. Very easy. With different types of front wheels or with the bare wheelchair, you always have to brake with both hands on both sides and push to keep the same speed and direction. Here is a small roll test. Hardly visible, but still there, this street has, like most paths, very slight side inclination. So my colleague has to brake on one side in order to keep the lane and direction. And I can steer with one hand directly with the handlebar and with the other hand even hold the camera. Another important point to make yourself efficient with the wheelchair to move is track stability. As you can see here, a lot of corrective movements are necessary to keep the wheelchair on course. Brake on one side, push on the other side, which is exhausting. With the Fossara and the unique track stability, you don't have to push it and just roll by itself. Even without having a hand on a handlebar, you can move safely and predictably. Driving downhill in a wheelchair is not always safe. You can burn your hands when braking on the hand rims. And if you want to stop to lock the brakes, then sometimes you have to be very fast, because the wheelchair can turn away as soon as you release a hand rim. With the front wheel, which we test here, we have to notice that it turns a lot when it is down the slope. The Fossara has a brake, which saves you from burnt hands. In addition, standing on the mountain without any hectic pace, you can safely and simply lock the wheelchair brakes and release it again. You need trunk stability to go downhill, otherwise you fly out of the wheelchair. For me, this maneuver would not be possible with this bike. With the Fossara, it looks different. Thanks to the one-hand handlebar, I can support myself and brake the front wheel. So going downhill is a safe and easy thing. If it is not only steep, but also uneven, the whole thing will be much more difficult, because you have to correct constantly the braking force on both sides to keep the lane. With the Fossara, it looks very different. Here again, the one-hand handlebar, and the whole thing is simple, safe and fun. Additional electric drives, such as the Smooth, make it easier and faster to move forward. The whole thing gets even better in connection with front wheels. If you don't want to brake on one side all the time and have the feeling that your hand burns, you need a handlebar. Thanks to the one-hand steering and additional braking power from the front brake, the connection of the additional drive and Fossara V3 is great for everyday use. Simple and modular, each part can be used individually for itself, and the wheelchair is and remains a wheelchair with few attachments and is small, light and compact to load. What does your wheelchair look like? Do you have additional drives, attachment wheels or adaptive bikes? What have you done to achieve the greatest possible mobility in everyday life? Let us know in the comments. If you enjoyed the video, like or subscribe us. See you next time at Dom's Wheel World.